Today we're going to try to repair the battery for the Asus netbook. This battery is the A321-DO15, and there's also a similar one, the A311-CO15, which only differs in its power. I have two batteries, one original Asus, and one Chinese equivalent, and neither of them works. Basically, you can throw them away, or you can try to make one out of them. So let's get started. Here's the battery. We insert it in netbook. Charge is zero. The connected one is charging. It's recommended to replace the battery. Let's check it with the ADA program. It shows that the wear level is 95%. Let's catch the battery. Zero. Low charge. Actually, it doesn't take any charge at all. This is the original battery that came with the netbook. Asus company. Lithium-ion. Let's take it apart and find out what's wrong with it. But first we need to check the voltage at the battery outputs. There are two symbols on the battery connector. Plus and minus. So the outer connectors are the terminals. It is not possible to insert probes here to check voltage, so I use regular needles. Gently insert it until it touches the contacts. And we can check the voltage. We're setting the tester to check voltage to 20 volts of direct current. The voltage is zero. This indicates a battery malfunction. Let's start taking it apart. You can try to carefully and gently open it with a flat screwdriver or an old plastic card. We're getting it started slowly and cautiously at the edge, with precision and a bit of patience. Let's start unclicking it. I managed to get the case off. It got a bit damaged, but I'll glue it back when I assemble it. Here's the brand of the original batteries and the battery management board. We're taking out the entire battery pack and the control board. Let's see what's inside. It was glued on. The material substance looks like silicone. We're measuring the voltage on the paired cells. 2.3, 1.6, and the last one is actually zero. So the problem is mainly with these two cells. Here's one of them that's swollen. You can see it's puffed up. We carefully peel it off, trying not to damage the plate itself, because we can solder it back later. This is the kind of battery we have. One is already clearly swollen. And the second one shows signs of swelling. These batteries are already definitely faulty, so we need to find replacements. Let's take a similar defective battery that I bought at the radio market. Only 31. It's completely identical, but it has a lower capacity. And let's see what kind of batteries it has. Maybe they'll work for replacing the damaged cells. It's opened. We take the batteries out of their spots and check their name. Here we have Samsung 8650. We measure 11.8 on all the cells. Now for each one individually. 3.9, 3.93. The central one turns out to be the strongest, so we'll take it as a donor. Along with the first cell, because the last one shows some defects. Here's the controller. They look completely identical on both batteries. After that, we disconnect the welding of the batteries, and then we can start soldering. So here's the controller, and by appearance, they are completely identical on both batteries. After that, we carefully disconnect the welding of the batteries, and then we can start the soldering process, step by step. and we put the controller back in place. We are in the process of closing up the battery compartment. This step is important to ensure everything is securely sealed and protected, maintaining the battery's integrity. For now, I'll temporarily tape the battery together. I can use electrical tape. Upon activation, we turn on ADA, and the system indicates that currently the battery is at a mere 4% health, which is a very low charge level. The tightness level is 92%. The battery voltage is 11.103, 102 volts, angle 4%. Available connected charging. Available connected charging. Let's wait for it to charge and see how it will work. So, my experiments with repacking the original Asus battery turned out to be unsuccessful, because after I put in new batteries, it started showing that it was 97% worn out, with only 3% left, and it worked for 10 minutes before shutting off. Let's try to figure out its copy. I also have a battery that I bought for not very much, for 500 hryvnias, and it also stopped working. The copy has a similar appearance. There are fewer labels here. The original has more. There's an Asus label here. It says replace. A31CE15. 32CE15. And here just says A31-1015. And it feels similar in weight. It's also a bit heavy. I've already opened it. And we can take a look at what's inside. And there were fewer cracks. And this is what it looks like. Inside the battery, it's unclear what brand it is. But my problem is that it shows a full charge. And then after 10 minutes, it's down to zero. The control board looks identical on the outside. Here's the original, the bottom one, and this is the copy. The details are slightly shifted. If the original has the label GTW18, then this one just has T5. The batteries are glued with some sticky glue that still hasn't dried. We also desolder from the smallest to the largest so that the controller doesn't get locked up. The wires here are much thinner. The outer negative is connected with a regular wire. There are no terminals for the temperature sensor at all, so it's a simplified battery management board. For repacking, I'm going to use standard branded Samsung cells with the same voltage. I'm going to take the terminal strips from the original cell. It's tough to solder the contacts to the battery terminals even, with a 40 watt soldering iron, so I'm using...
When working with electronics, using a more powerful soldering iron, such as one with a 65 watt capacity, can significantly enhance your soldering experience. This type of soldering iron provides the necessary heat to make the soldering process much smoother and more efficient. However, it's crucial to be cautious and avoid overheating the battery during this process, as excessive heat can damage the battery and potentially lead to safety hazards. To address the issue of fitting the battery into its designated case, especially when the battery seems too large, we employ a meticulous technique. This involves taking a small, precise file and carefully filing down any protrusions or irregularities on the battery contacts. This step is essential to ensure a snug fit within the case, which is important for both the functionality and safety of the device. By paying attention to these details, we can achieve a successful and safe assembly of the electronic components. Unfortunately, one of my contacts broke, so I'm using copper foil. I'm very slowly and carefully cutting a strip of the same size and precisely. The copper foil is even better than the original, which is a significant improvement in terms of performance and quality. I'll very carefully measure it to the best of my ability according to the size of the battery and solder it. Now we carefully and gently put the control board back into its original position and securely solder the contacts. We start from the starting point of the minimum voltage and go to the ending point of the maximum. Now we can assemble the battery all together. Here's the battery assembled, and we can try testing it. The most enjoyable and exciting time has come for testing the battery. I have an Asus 1215B netbook, and here's a repaired battery installed in it. So, let's start it up and check.
In the bottom right corner, the icon shows 85%. There are 2 hours and 29 minutes left.
The testing showed that if you have original batteries, repacking them is impossible, because you'll need to reflash the power controller. If you have a copy though, a beginner can do it easily. I suggest you buy batteries with welded tabs right away to make cell packing easier later. If you have a copy, then even a novice craftsman can do it without any problems, provided he has the most basic skills. Based on my initial experience, I would like to advise you to buy batteries with welded tires right away, because this will make it easier to pack the cans of the entire battery later. Because I struggled for about an hour, resoldering those thin copper plates to fit everything neatly into this case. It's really narrow and small, and it's tough to cram all 6 batteries in there. You can use old batteries and flashlights, screwdrivers, or other electrical devices. Because it's really narrow and small, and it's tough to cram those 6 batteries in there, you can use old batteries and flashlights, screwdrivers, or other electrical devices. They will still come in handy. You've watched the video on how to repack the battery of your favorite laptop or netbook by yourself. There's nothing complicated about it, but there are certain nuances. Leave your comments and feedback, and don't forget to like. Subscribe to our channel. Stay with us. Goodbye, everyone.